Hello everyone, today I am going to start with a new topic, that is transport in semiconductors. In our previous classes we have studied about general properties of semiconductors, classification of semiconductors, carrier concentration, Fermi energy and dependence on temperature as well as impurity concentration. From today's class we are going to study different phenomena which is related to transport within the semiconductor, which is due to the carriers itself. First, let us start with electrical conductivity. Electrical conductivity quantity is of primary importance or interest in case of semiconductors, because based on this quantity only we can decide which type of semiconductor is suitable for any practical application. In semiconductors, we know that both electrons as well as holes are responsible for electrical current flow. In order to derive the equation for electrical conductivity, let us consider a strongly n-type semiconductor. That is a sample with only one type of carrier, which is nothing but electron. We have a theory which is called a semi-classical transport theory, according to which there are four different types of transport occurring, or four different types of currents. First one is the drift current, which is caused due to the electric field or caused by electric fields, and the direction is always in the direction of electric field applied. Second type of current is thermoelectric current. Thermo means temperature, and this type of current is caused due to the temperature differences. Third type of current is the diffusion current, which is caused due to variation in carrier concentration, and the direction depends on the gradient of carrier concentration. Fourth type of current is the tunneling current, which is caused when an electron or a carrier moves through a barrier, which is classically not possible, but quantum mechanically it is possible. That's why this tunneling current is a quantum mechanical phenomena. So, in order to derive the equation, let us start. That is, first we need to apply electric field so that there will be transport of the carriers. That is, in our case, it is strongly n-type, means electrons are going to move. So, when an electric field is exerted or applied, electrons drift opposite to the field and carry a net electric current. Electrons drift in opposite direction because of the negative charge of it. And from free electron model, as the electrons are represented by effective mass Me star, electrical conductivity can be just taken as sigma E, which is the electrical conductivity due to electron, is equals to Me square tau E divided by Me star. Tau E is nothing but lifetime of electron. Me star is the effective mass. So this is a general equation which is derived from the free electron model. If you put the values, which are some standard values, in place of N, that is 10 raised to 15 per centimeter cube. If you convert it in terms of meters, it will be 10 raised to 21 per meter cube. And tau E, let us say it is equals to 10 raised to minus 12 second. And effective mass is 0.1 times of rest mass of electron. If you substitute in the above equation, we get sigma E, which is the electrical conductivity due to the electrons as carriers. It will be approximately equal to 1 per ohm per meter. So this is a typical value of electrical conductivity in case of semiconductors. Generally, if you consider for metals, electrical conductivity is of the order 10 raised to 7 per ohm per meter. So even if sigma E, that is electrical conductivity for semiconductor, is very less ordered when compared to metals, still sigma E is sufficiently large in case of semiconductors with respect to practical applications. That's why semiconductors are very important type of materials when we go for practical applications. So sigma E, that is electrical conductivity, is small in case of semiconductors because carrier concentration, that is N, is also small when compared to metals. For metals, we can say that N is of the order 10 raised to 28 per meter cube. But in case of semiconductors, it is of the order 10 raised to 21 per meter cube. That's why there is a difference with respect to electrical conductivity order also. So we can say that as the carrier concentration is going on increasing, electrical conductivity also goes on increasing because sigma is directly proportional to N, which is a carrier concentration. E is a constant, tau E is the lifetime of electron, and Me star is the effective mass. So sigma E, which is giving you the electrical conductivity, depends on all these factors. So let us derive this equation. We have Ohm's law, which gives the equation I is equals to V by R. Also, we define current density J equal to I by A, that is current per unit area is nothing but current density. Next, we have resistance as R is equals to rho L by A, and that's why rho will be equal to R A by L. And also, conductivity sigma is the reciprocal of resistivity rho. That's why we write sigma is equals to 1 by rho. If you substitute the value of rho, which is equals to R A by L, we get sigma is equals to L by A R, because both are reciprocals. In place of R, we can just substitute from the Ohm's law, which is R is equals to V by I. So when you substitute, you can just collect the term I by A and L by V. I by A is nothing but current density, J I have substituted, and V by L is nothing but electric field, that is potential difference divided by the length. So this term is going to give you the electric field. So we can see that conductivity sigma is equals to J by E. So if you just cross multiply, you get current density J is equals to sigma into E. Let us say it as equation number 1. If you consider Newton's law, that is force is equals to mass into acceleration, we can write acceleration as a time rate of change of velocity. So I have taken m star is the effective mass into acceleration dv by dt will be equal to the force. Force I have considered minus E into E, which is nothing but the Lorentz force, and minus m star v divided by tau is the frictional force. V is the velocity of electron, tau is the collision time. So this RHS side is nothing but the force, LHS side is mass into acceleration, which is nothing but Newton's second law. So if you consider this as equation number 2, then we have a steady state solution, which is dv by dt is equals to 0, that is velocity is constant, rate of change of velocity which gives you the acceleration will be 0, that is nothing but the steady state solution. If you substitute this dv by dt equal to 0 in equation number 2, we can say force minus E into capital E minus m star v by tau is equals to 0. If you just rearrange it, we get the drift velocity v is equals to, or vd is equals to, minus E tau by m star into capital E, which is electric field. Because both are having negative signs, one will be jumping to RHS side and all other terms are brought on the RHS side, keeping V on LHS. So this is the expression for drift velocity. Again, another point to remember is the frictional force or the viscous force, what you can say, it tends to reduce V to zero, that is velocity to zero. And that's why that we can be considered under the steady state solution. So after this, let us solve for J, because we have J is equals to sigma into V, sigma into capital E. In order to find out sigma, we are using J. We have another standard equation, which is J is equals to minus Ne Vd. Minus Ne is nothing but the charge per unit volume into the drift velocity. Already we have calculated what is drift velocity. When you substitute, you get the equation of J is equals to Ne square tau by m star into E. And also we have from equation number 1, J is equals to sigma into E. So when you compare these two equations, directly we can observe in place of sigma, we are having a term Ne square tau by m star. That's why we can equate these two and say that electrical conductivity sigma is equals to Ne square tau by m star. So this is the expression which gives the details about electrical conductivity in case of semiconductors. So in our next session, we will be discussing about the mobility in case of semiconductors. Thank you.